Hello Gemini, how are you? It is me, Lauren B. Welcome to the Untitled Tarot. We are here to do your mini monthly for November. We're gonna do these in lieu of the Element by Design readings. So what we're gonna do is we have six cards for you. We have a general energy for you leaving October, and then we have four cards representing each week of the month, and then sort of a conclusion general energy at the end here. It's very interesting in November coming for you, Gemini. So we'll say a little prayer and then we'll get into it. Yes? Very good. Father God, thank you for being here with me and my Geminis today. I ask that we bring forward messages and guidance in Gemini's highest of love, light, alignment, and assignment for November. I ask that you bless these messages and you cover these cards. We praise you and we thank you. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Amen, Gemini. So, the first card that you have out for November is the Ouroboros. This is the Wheel of Fortune. Oh, we're using the Mystical Dream Tarot, by the way. This is the Ouroboros. This is the Wheel of Fortune. Turning in your favor, upright, Gemini, moving into November. So that's very, very good. And what I always notice in this card is that it's almost like a little bit of like an assembly line. Things kind of coming together. Things moving with a greater flow, a greater ease. Right? Things kind of coming into place for you, running smoothly, leaving October and going into November. So that's beautiful. And with this big lizard, that often signifies like a death and rebirth energy as well. So it could be changing the way that you ran things with this fire in the past, right? The way you prioritize people, places, and things, your time, your energy, you're shifting that come the beginning of November. And that's allowing the Wheel of Fortune to turn in your favor, things to run smoothly for you, and also for you to feel at a greater ease and flow in the pace in which you're going about your day-to-day life. So that's really beautiful. So the first week of November, we have the Seven of Cups in reverse. So the thing that always sticks out to me in the Seven of Cups is it includes your masculine and feminine parts, which is beautiful. And this beetle up here represents sort of divine magic and serendipity, trying to come in on both aspects of you, right? In a very uniformed way. But there's a big tower in the middle of it, right? So towers often come when we have Seven of Cups. We have choices, usually too many of them. Seven of Cups is usually represented. You're looking for options because you're not satisfied with the options that you have. Now, in reverse, what this is telling me in the first week of November is that by making a decision, not playing around, toying around, I'm hearing, with too many different options in your life, in your mind, in your heart, come the first week of November, that you will actually have a tower in reverse. You will avoid a shakeup. You will avoid an upset. You will avoid a tower moment by making some kind of decision, cutting out something, someone, too many options, making a decision in the first week of November. Now, from the second week in November, we have the Ace of Pentacles. Now, this is beautiful. Now that we've made a decision about something, we can start to work on it. Now, the thing I love about this Ace of Pentacles is that it is very much reminiscent of a Six of Pentacles energy, right? An equal give and take. Realizing now that we've made a decision, kind of taken some of the excess off of our plate, right? That now we have the energy to really go into more of a servitude sort of vibration, where we're really also realizing that fortune often goes in our favor, you know, favor, kindness, mercy. Things go better for us when we're acting out of a place of servitude, right? When we're acting out of the goodness of our heart, when we're extending energy to help other people as well, right? Not just ourselves, but giving, being in a giving spirit, a loving spirit, an open spirit, right? Not scarcity mindset, not poverty mindset, not afraid of being vulnerable, that we're going to lose something if we give a little something. Being very free and very open in that. That's a big bird. Holy smokes, you can get some messages come November, Gemini. But it really is a beautiful place to start building something with love, with energy putting out into it, and also with the intention of not just going on it, just going about it like on your own too, like bringing and helping other people up with you as well, which is gorgeous. So come the third week in November, we have the Five of Pentacles. Now the imagery in this deck speaks so much more than the suits, so don't get too wrapped up in the suits, but again, we have this fish, right? So fish represent flow. They represent movement. They represent abundance in all of its forms. Now, inside this fish, it's almost like it's like a little picture, right? With this little feminine depiction in here. And it is the sense of, I think perhaps in scaling back, making a decision about who to be with, what to do, how you want to spend your time, how you want to spend your energy, being in a place. Perhaps when things start going in your favor, you're in more of a loving and a giving spirit, right? You feel like things are going in your favor, so you don't have to hold on to so much control. That in doing that, I think the third week of November, it really is kind of like a little bit of a reminiscing time for you, a little bit of that a personal accounting, right? Of ways in which you receive abundance, way in which you receive flow and movement in any of its forms, and ways in the past and how that differ, how perhaps formerly, maybe leaving October and maybe further along in your past, that things that you were receiving weren't in your highest of good. Maybe they weren't in your flow. Maybe they weren't in the greatest of your abundance, and how shifting your energy, your mindset, your perspective, and really approaching things from more of an open vibration, how that's allowed you to receive more abundance, receive more love, more flow, more momentum. Now we wrap up the end of the month with the Three of Cups. Now this is gorgeous. This is a celebratory energy, the Three of Cups. It's also very communal energy. But the thing I love about this card is that you have this big cauldron, right? A little bit like in the Hierophant card that we have in this deck as well. And we have these two moons here. There's a castle up here, kind of an arrow right up there, right? Arrows representing momentum up, with the cauldron of the Hierophant and the arrow pointing up to the castle and this big line that talks about being kingdom-minded, right? That goes again back to this being kind of simpler living, not needing so much, being grateful and thankful for what we have and being very generous of spirit also with others and what we have and how that helps our flow and our abundance when we're being more kingdom-minded. But I think that come the end of November, you will have a greater appreciation for the things that you have, the love that you've been able to receive, the love that you are now feeling more free to give out onto others, right? And it's really going to be a very spiritual moment for you. Again, this arrow pointing up towards the kingdom, right? Really, if you felt a little detached or distant from God or from your guardian angels and your angels, I feel as a sense it's a real coming home. It's a real coming home energy, and that in and of itself is a cause for celebration, which is beautiful. And then your confirming general energy is the Ace of Wands. And I think it's realizing after everything that you've been through and everything you've been able to overcome, that being in a generous spirit, being connected with God, being connected with your inner emotions, with your higher self, you allow yourself to be a bit like a lotus, a bit like a lily, right? That despite any muddy circumstances that you may have been in the past, that despite that, you've grown beautifully, despite any obstacles that you've faced. And now you're at peace with your past, and with wands being fiery, excited, passionate energy, you're looking forward to the future now that you have this new balanced perspective, right? Now that you've kind of reconnected with God and seen more fortune, mercy, kindness, favor kind of following you, as well as momentum too, so that energy isn't so stuck, it's not so stagnant like it was for you towards the end of October. And you've really allowed you to blossom, make peace with the past, be moving into your future in a very excited way, but not in a snatch and grab, right? Being peaceful and excited, just in the sense of being happy, looking forward with positivity, this new mindset, right? With all these lily pads, it is a sense that come November, you will have jumped to a higher timeline for yourself in making this perspective switch. A change in perspective can change your life, any and always. So I think that's really beautiful. And this is also coming in like a little bit like the Statue of Liberty for me right now as well. So it is a liberation, kind of breaking the chains off, blooming, blossoming spiritually, emotionally, in terms of projects and stability, things that you're working on in all different aspects. It's really, really gorgeous. It's really gorgeous, Gemini. So I really like that for you come November, because I know you've had a rough couple weeks. So this was your mini monthly for November. I hope that you enjoyed it. If you're interested in your full monthly reading, that is on the Patreon. If you are interested in a personal monthly reading, I do offer those in addition to the regular personals that I do. My email's in the description box with the Patreon, along with all of my social media links and all the decks that I use. This was the Mystical Dream Tarot. If you'd like to get it for yourself, that is in there. I love you guys very much. I hope that you enjoyed these mini monthlies. Thank you so much for coming and spending this time with me. I really do appreciate it. I love all my baby bees. And until I see you next time, Gemini, in your weeklies, or until I see you on the Patreon, I love you. Stay prayed up, stay blessed, and enjoy November. God bless.